The Patriotic League of Uganda, under the leadership of Chief of the Uganda People's Defense Forces, General Muhoozi Kainerugaba, is grieving the loss of its deputy spokesperson for Buganda, Tamale Mirundi. Speaking to the press, a PLU Central Committee at their offices in Naguru expressed their condolences to the family and friends of Tamale. Michael Nuagira Kaguta, known as Toyota, and the National Vice Chairman of PLU expressed profound sorrow for the loss of one of PLU's founder members, who is eulogized for his firm beliefs.
It's on a sad note that we lost one of our founders of PLU, our big supporter who has started the PLU. He has been... Tamale Mirundi is a guy who speaks his mind. If he has a point, even if you do what, he will never change it. And he will stick to his point until the last. He has been a support of NRM, a support of PLU. We have lost an intelligent person. And as PLU, he has been our spokesperson for Buganda. And we shall always miss him.
Frank Gashumba, the PLU Vice Chairman for Buganda, also honored Mirundi's long-standing support for General Kainerugaba and his extensive knowledge. Balam Barugahara, the Minister of State for Youth and Children, and also the PLU Vice Chairman for Central Uganda, described Mirundi as a media warrior, fighter, liberator, and great mobilizer, emphasizing his dedication to transparency and free speech.
General Muhoozi Kainerugaba has been a friend with Tamale Mirundi for the last 20 years. They have been so close. Even there are times when, as members, we could develop disagreements. But then he keeps reminding you that that one is your elder brother. We have had the ups and downs with Tamale, but he was a frank man. He would believe and speak what he believed in.
At the time of his death, Tamale was the Patriotic League of Uganda's spokesperson for Buganda region, whose intellect and forthright nature made him a remarkable figure, and his passing on leaves a void that will be deeply felt. The brother of the late outspoken political commentator Tamale Mirundi has appealed for forgiveness for his siblings' past transgressions. John Salis Mbuya made the appeal during a requiem mass held for Mirundi at St. Javira Parish Catholic Church in Bunamwaya. Sembuya also announced his intention to seek for forgiveness from the category of Buganda for any wrongdoings committed by his brother. He clarified the widely circulated statement attributed to Mirundi, which claimed that his body should not be taken to church upon his death. He explained that the statement was taken out of context, asserting that his brother had expressed a desire not to have his body disrespected by a specific priest, Father Chibi.
Malai niye ya, the dead is the damned. Sini njokiri na yi, kura famire. Namu bonna abalala abawulira nti abadde abayisiza bubi tusobole okumalawo ebintu ebyo ate bonnaffe awummule mirembe.
He appreciated President Yoweri Museveni for the support he gave towards the treatment and recovery of his late sibling. The requiem mass attracted various officials from central government, including Minister for Kampala Capital City and Metropolitan Affairs, Hajat Minsa Kavanda, IGG Olive Kamia, and former VP Chiwanuka Sekandi, among others. In her speech, Minister Kavanda expressed condolences from the government to the bereaved family and said the government has taken over the burial arrangements for the late Tamale Mirundi.
Mirundi decided, for his personal reasons, not to enter office. Therefore, on the basis of this appointment, the President's office alongside State House have committed to cover the costs for this burial with his position.
With about 15.8 million Ugandan national IDs set to expire between August 2024 and December 2025, the government has decided to extend the validity of all these cards by 1 year. The State Minister of Internal Affairs, General David Muhoozi, told the Committee of Defense in Parliament today that the government is behind schedule to process national IDs.
On Monday in the Gazette, us, so this should sort the anxiety that was starting in the public regarding what do we do between now and when we get the new ID. So the IDs that were due to expire in that period will be extended by 1 year.
General David Mohozi explained that earlier the government had planned for June 2024 for mass enrollment exercise, faced by delay occasioned by the due diligence that had to be conducted on the company that was meant to deliver national security system, thus the decision to change the expiry dates. He added that the extension would be done through the Statutory Instrument Amendment No. 2, Regulations 2024, already published in the Gazette on the 12th of August 2024. In May, Minister Mohozi said registration for mass issuance of IDs to new citizens as well as the renewal exercise was set to start on June 1st and would run up to September 30th, 2025. But mass enrollment exercise was pushed back by a month before appearing to go in an indefinite wait, with NIR Executive Director Rose Kisembo saying the exercise had to be postponed due to unforeseen circumstances. NIRA is also required to deliver data to the Electoral Commission by 30th November 2024, which will be used as the National Voters Register ahead of 2026 general elections.